This is my New Year's resolution. Kidding. I have no very special plans for this year, but there are a few things I want to pay more attention to. One of them is to give you more videos in English, so I'm starting to voice over the videos from this year, the new videos from 2019, in English. I hope you enjoy it. There is another point that was brought to my attention by you, and it seems so neglectable, but actually it makes up for a lot of our synthetic waste, and that's the use of plastic in everyday life, like dish sponges, makeup removal pads, and things like that. You showed to me how easy it is to knit and crochet such tiny items for yourself with cotton yarn, and while I was suspicious at first sight, your arguments convinced me, and so I gave that topic a more thorough thought. So if you want to make your own dish sponges or dishcloths and your makeup removal pads and pot holders and things like that, you need structured stitches. So I found a lot of stitches eligible, and we start with a very, very simple stitch consisting of one row and four stitches only. You need a number of stitches divisible by 4 plus 2. And maybe you notice that I'm using rather thin needles for the thickness of the yarn, because whenever you work things like dishcloth and pot holders and makeup removal pads, you should work very, very tightly. So use smaller needles than you would usually. So I casted on 20 stitches plus 2, 22 stitches, and we work the edge stitches. We knit them always, first and last stitch knit pattern. Knit one through the back loop, purl one, knit one. That's it. Just repeat. Knit one through the back loop, purl one, knit one. And repeat. Knit one through the back loop, purl one, and knit one. Four stitches, repeat. Knit one through the back loop, purl one, and knit one. Once again, knit one through the back loop, purl one, knit one, and knit the edge stitch. That's it. It's just one row, and you repeat this row on the right side and on the wrong side. So this results in a sort of waffle stitch or pleat stitch. If you're bored by this very simple stitch, try small modification. Knit the edge stitch, then knit one through the back loop. Now purl one through the back loop, knit one. And again, knit one through the back loop, purl one through the back loop, and knit one. Knit one through the back loop, purl one through the back loop. It's a little bit tricky to purl through the back loop, but this stitch is a good training for learning it. And knit one. And you repeat that throughout the row. Now there is a tiny difference. in the structure, but you will see it. I'm working a few more rows to show you the difference. So if you look here, the first few rows with only the knit stitch worked through the back loop, and the other rows, the knit stitch and the purl stitch worked through the back loop. The difference is that in the second part you have the back loop stitches in every row, and in the first part you only have them in every second row. In the upper part, those pleats look more carved out and more tidy. So this is a very, very simple stitch. You only need to remember four stitches for a structured texture, which is not only suitable for dishcloth, pot holders, makeup removal pads, but also for socks, for example, or for men's hats and more stuff. Enjoy.